Hi, so the Omicron variant B11529 is officially a new variant of COVID-19 recognized by the WHO on November 24th, 2021. And it seems that now we are playing against professionals rather than amateurs, which we did last year. And this variant is so concerning at multiple levels. And today, by the end of this video, you will learn about why this is very concerning variants in terms of transmissibility, spread, contagiousness, and if the vaccines and the natural immunity is still effective against this new variant. I am Dr. Omar Danoun. So the Omicron variant was first identified in South Africa, but that because of the surveillance system tightly surveilling and looking at all the COVID vaccine viruses, and when they noticed a huge spike in their cases over a 2 weeks period, they learned that there is a new variant that we're dealing with, and they recognized the Omicron variant. But that does not mean that it originated from South Africa. It was detected in South Africa. Now it's spread in almost all the countries over the world, we know it or not. The first question, can this new variant escape the immunity? This variant is very concerning. We know from older variants, there were a couple of mutations in the critical site. However, this variant has more than 32 mutations in the critical site of the protein called the S protein, the spike protein. This virus protein is responsible for latching on in your nose and lungs and causing the infection. And this is also the place where the immunity attacks the virus and neutralizes it. So this can potentially lead to lower immune response, and our immunity will not be as effective, and our vaccines might not be as effective. However, the definite answer will come in about 2 weeks. We are actively testing the new variant against our natural immunity and the immunity we get from the vaccines. But honestly, now we hope that our vaccines can protect us from severe illness and hospitalization, and you might get an infection, but it will be mild or unrecognizable. So even if you got COVID-19 already, the WHO estimates that you can be reinfected by this new variant. So it is a major concern. The second question is that, is this virus more transmissible? Can it be more contagious? And the answer is likely yes, so much more, because all of those mutations in the spike protein makes it more sticky to the cells and cause more infection. So the R-naught, which this is mysterious number that how many people can you infect if you have the virus, for the original Wuhan virus was 2.79, which means that if you have the virus, you can spread it to two or three people around you. The Delta variant, which is spreading throughout the world at a record levels and speed, the R-naught number is 5. That means that if you have the virus, you can spread it to 5 and 50 and then 500 and 5,000, and the spread is much, much more faster. And then the worst virus we ever had is the measles, and the R-naught number is 15. So it is estimated that all those 32 mutations make the R-naught number is way more than that, and it will be multiple times more than the Delta variants, which means that within a few weeks, it will spread throughout the world and will be so many cases infected as we see this virus spreading. But only time will tell. So this means that any sneeze or cough or any connection with anybody who is infected with the virus can get the virus. Instead of before, you have to have lots of viral particles, sneeze or shake hand or get those mucus into your system. It seems that before we were dealing with a sticky paper note, and now we're dealing with a duct tape. And then the second question is, can the Omicron variant lead to more severe illness? Means that if you get the virus, can you be more sick and more deadly? Well, so far we don't know for sure, and we are closely monitoring this. However, if you have multiple numbers of cases and so much more people infected, lots of people will end up in the ICU and then will die. So overall, the death toll might be much more than the previous viruses because of the huge number of people infected. We also should not ignore the fact that if you get COVID-19 infection and you don't die, you still can have long-term side effects and long hauler effects, that all of those memory issues and smell loss and headache and all of the things that I see in my clinic on a regular basis, people are suffering from the long consequences of COVID-19. Well, how can we protect ourselves against this Omicron variant? Well, the answer is getting vaccinated. So get your first vaccine shot, get the second shot, and if you were fully vaccinated, get the booster shot. Having those in place, the stronger immunity we can fight this virus on the society level. However, on your own level, you can continue to keeping your guard up. Do not let your guard down. Keep masking, keep hand hygiene, social distancing, all the measures that we know for sure that it can prevent the spread of the virus. So continue doing that to prevent the society spread. And on a global level, it is very important to get everybody vaccinated. It is more important to vaccinate South Africa than vaccinating New York and Paris. Why is that? Because if we don't vaccinate South Africa and other low-income countries, then the virus will still be mutating and will reach our shores and will render our vaccines ineffective. So instead of banning travel from those countries, I suggest you send them vaccines so that the virus will stop spreading. And to learn more about those long-term effects of COVID-19, you can see those videos and see you in the next one.